Shalom from Israel, from the most southern spot in Israel, here at the Gulf of Aqaba. We're standing here at a beautiful place called the Coral Beach, where we, as divers, I myself, a diver, open water diver, it's a paradise for diving because of the coral. And at the back we see the underwater observatory, and then behind we see borders of Egypt, with Egypt, and as you know, the Gulf of Aqaba, where we're standing right now, is bordered next to four countries. We're standing in Israel, there we have Egypt, and on the other side of the sea, we have Saudi Arabia, and then we're going more east, under the beautiful mountain of Edom. Adam means red, that's why it's called the Red Sea, by the way. And underneath we see the town called Aqaba, the Jordanian town. And then we're going more north, we see the beautiful hotels. It is already the Israeli side, and this is Eilat. That's a summer paradise for many Israelis. As you can see, many Israelis are right now enjoying the sea. It's very hot right now. It's a very extreme heat, by the way, here at the Gulf of Aqaba today. But, you know, today we have only Israeli local people coming to this place, tourism, because foreigners cannot come because of the corona, COVID-19. And so what's the story about Eilat, the most southern city of Israel? There is history, even in the Bible. We read in the Bible about a place called Etzion Geber. This was a trade harbor or port city from the time of King Solomon, when he did his trade, income, outcome, you know, all the export income and the import from Africa, coming all the way from Africa, the Queen of Sheba, remember? This all come through the Gulf of Aqaba into the land of Israel. By the way, we are not far away from here, from those copper mines, right? They come from the time of King Solomon, when he had his copper mines here, and then also export the copper to all the region. So this is also a special place here at the Gulf of Aqaba. By the way, this place was the last place conquered by the Israeli army in the 20th century at the War of Independence. In March 1949, this city, Eilat, in those days it was called Rashash, only a police station by the Brits, this city was conquered and taken. And more or less, after conquest of this city, the war ended. And that's why also our first Prime Minister, David Ben-Gurion, called it not, like the Bible says, from Dan to Beersheba. He called it from now on, from Dan to Eilat. From that place we are standing right now, and I want to greet you all and wish you all the blessing. God bless you all. Michael Schneider from the Gulf of Aqaba.